Distinguished guests, administrators, faculty, staff, students, family, and friends. Dottavio, I bring you greetings from Heidelberg University and from the thousands of individuals whose lives have been touched by your work and your friendship. Now, you have to understand that my first contact with Tarleton State University was when I phoned your chancellor, Mike McKinney. After the usual greetings of how are yous, which I didn't answer truthfully, he said to me, "What can I do for you?" To which I responded, "You can give him back." Of course, he chuckled, and of course I didn't. It wasn't a great moment in relationship building because the next task I had was to tell him that my board had voted to sue your university for what we considered to be a robbery to rival the intact canon robbery. However, Dr. Dottavio assured us he was not being whisked away against his will, and so we backed down, and in sincere friendship, went into advice mode on his move to Texas. We gave him a shopping list and a to-do list, both of which were immediately rejected. As we had only ever seen him in suits and knew he did not own a single pair of jeans. Well, jeans were at the top of that shopping list. Instantly, he responded that he would never wear jeans. Next, we encouraged him to buy a Stetson. Never, ever, ever would he wear a hat of any kind, much less a Stetson. This was said with great conviction. We suggested chaps. Now, we had to explain to him what they were. And once more, he shouted, "No." We asked if he had ever ridden a horse, maybe a pony when he was a little kid or something like that. We asked that he and Lisette go for dance lessons and learn the Texas two-step. When all our offers of advice failed, we offered to think of a brand for him, and of course that was the easiest task of all because he immediately became the Double D. Dominic, I have seen the photos, and I'm glad to see you have finally accepted the inevitable and acclimated to Texas, to Stephenville, and to Tarleton. You look very comfortable and at home in the saddle. Today I have the great honor of representing Dr. Dottavio's friends. This is a large task, as he has been so many things to so many people. He has been orange and purple. He's been blue. He's been black and gold. Red and gray. Orange, red, and black. And now purple again. Sounds like he was in an old-fashioned Texas brawl, but no, I'm referring to all his schools. Looking at it another way, he's been a Clemson Tiger, a Yalie, a Purdue Boilermaker, an Ohio State Buckeye, and a student prince, which is Heidelberg's representative. And with regards to that, I understand that you're very proud that your Texans and I believe it's the Plowboys have been in the magazine. I want you to know that Heidelberg University has been the answer most often to questions of Jeopardy with regards to unusual mascots. Being a tenacious tiger, he has saved trees, water, and other natural resources, our beaches and endangered species such as whales, wolves, panthers, and bears. He has worked to save the Navy, the Cape Hatteras Lighthouse, the Everglades, our environment, and our land. And he has saved students beyond count by his endless attention, interaction, and devotion to their well-being. Knowing what it means to be all colors of the rainbow, he has used a sense of color to enhance the colors and beauty of the environment wherever he has gone.
He used his Boilermaker's welding skills to mend fences and forge new partnerships to provide a unifying diplomacy that benefited all. From Russia to the Americas, from the White House to the President's House in Tarleton, he has been an animal, a color, a welder, and perhaps he really did need to be a Buckeye because it probably helped him if he were a little nutty. Tarleton, Heidelberg has given him to your care for his next transformation as a Texan. However, I leave you with one admonition. Treat him well, for he has been and always will be a prince.